all I can say is I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of you.
Hey guys, this is Blue Jays Talk, and there is reports that the Jays, once again have bidded for Yu Darvish, but this time it's reported it's the biggest offer, and they are close to winning. They won the rights to Yu Darvish. The reported offer is about 40 to 50 million, a bit closer to 50 million than it is 40 million. And Yu Darvish, he could be a game changer in MLB, or he can just start to suck. Like we know about Dice K from the Red Sox, he had two stellar seasons, and, you know, then injuries kind of hit him, and then, you know, now he's not, he's dropped, you know, he's not as good as he was. But Yu Darvish, looking at his stats, Yu Darvish came out with an 18-6 record last season with a 1.44 ERA, the lowest he has posted in the Japanese leagues. And, you know, I guess he was more mature last year, that's why he did so well. But he wasn't always that good, you know. The year before, in 2010, he posted 12-8 with a 1.78 ERA. A bit worse, but you know, the strikeouts were there. He got 222 strikeouts, but 2011 was just an amazing season for him. He got 276 strikeouts in 232 innings. That's like a strikeout per inning. That's like 9 strikeouts per game, more. Which is just, you know, amazing for a Japanese player, obviously, coming out of Japan. And, you know, Yu Darvish, if he comes to the Toronto Blue Jays, he can make an impact. You know, after 1-2, Ricky Romero, Brandon Morrow, then maybe Yu Darvish could come in third spot. If he plays somewhat like what he played in Japan to the majors, if he translates the same performance, you know, he maybe the Jays will have a significant playoff chance. And it will help with the Blue Jays. You know, Romero, he's pretty, I believe, got like 180 strikeouts. Romero got 200, and maybe Darvish could get 200. Who knows? But it will be a very good boost to the rotation. And you know, I hope the reports are true and the Jays can get him. There's also some other reporting news that Darren Oliver, who has been linked to the Toronto Blue Jays. This is no surprise that that the Jays are going after this guy, a left-handed reliever. You know, just the fact that the Jays only have one lefty reliever in Luis Perez, and then they have Evan Crawford, who has, you know, never had a major league appearance. And Darren Oliver had a pretty good season, actually. It was a career year for him in ERA, as he went 5-5, which, you know, is not bad, and a 2.29 ERA. And this guy is 41 years old, and, you know, he still did pretty good. If the Jays could add him to their bullpen, that would be a huge boost, you know. Maybe not setup man, but, like, just maybe long relief, you know. The Jays can really use some long relief, and Oliver would help. Last guy is Carlos Beltran. Carlos Beltran had a stellar year, going 22 home runs, 84 RBI. It's one of his worst seasons, but it's not like he did miserably. He didn't do bad, but you know, he's aging, and I'm not surprised if he produces worse. But if the Jays can get him in left field, as Eric Thames, you know, we can get an upgrade there. You know, he's not that experienced, and is he ready for left field for a whole season? Carlos Beltran had 22 home runs, 84 RBI, and a .300 batting average. The batting average was one of his best, but the 22 home runs and the 84 RBI were not, as, you know, in 2006, he had 41 home runs, and his highest RBI was 116 in the 41 home run season. No surprise. You know, there is a risk on Beltran. He's been injured the last, you know, couple seasons, 2010, 2009, but hopefully he can come to the Blue Jays and help them, because if he does, then that lineup just gets so much better, and the Jays just look more of a playoff team every day, linking to all these reports. And this is Blue Jays Talk 123 without the 123. Please subscribe and for more Blue Jay updates and player updates. But as of right now, it's Toronto Blue Jays.
Girl, you got it, girl, you got it. There you go. Can't you tell by how they looking at you everywhere?